Hello chess friends and welcome to the channel. Today is day 6 of the Legends of Chess and we have a new game by the legendary world champion Magnus Carlsen. After 5 rounds, Carlsen is the sole leader of the tournament and in today's match he plays against Ding Liren that instead is having one of the worst tournaments of his life. Game 1 played today with Ding with the white pieces ended with a draw. We are going to watch game 2 where is Carlsen with the white pieces. Let's get started. Magnus opens with d4, Ding Liren answers with knight to f6, c4, e6, knight to f3, d5, knight to c3, and here comes very good choice by Ding, c6. This is the semi-Slav. Bishop to g5 is the main line with the bishop out of the pawn chain and also pinning the knight. h6 immediately attacking the bishop is the Moscow variation. Bishop back to h4 and now d capture on c4. Here comes the e4 push. Now black must also pay attention to this e5. The light square bishop is attacking the pawn. So at first g5, bishop back to g3 and only now b5 protecting the pawn. Bishop to e2, bishop to b7, short castle for white and knight in b goes to d7. After 10 moves, there are more than 300 games in my database with this position. Knight to e5 is the main continuation, but Carlsen doesn't want to exchange this knight. Instead, he has other plans for it. In fact, he continues with knight back to d2. What to play now as black? Let's briefly watch the main continuation. Main continuation not played by Ding is h5, and of course the idea is to play h4. Now h3, g4 is very good because now it's better for white not to capture on g4, opening the dangerous h5 where there is that is already under control of the black's rook. So after g4 there is h4 and black is fine. Let's go back to our game. Instead, after knight back to d2, Ding continues with the second most played move, queen to b6, now with the queen attacking the unprotected central pawn. Only 4 games in database where all the white players indirectly defended this pawn with a4, and in fact this is the move that also Carlsen will play, a4. Now what happens? It happens that the queen can't move away, or the pawn and the knight will capture on b5. So here comes h6, but instead of h6, much better would have been the novelty now in this position, h5 g4. The game is going to transpose. Here comes e5, that comes with tempo against the knight, knight to d5, and now this knight moves to a beautiful square, knight to e4. This was Carlsen's idea, not to exchange this knight but to centralize the knight, and from e4 this knight is watching these two beautiful outposts, f6 and e6. Both moves will come with check, and the central pawn is now under the protection of the queen. So what to do now for black? The game transposed, and in database there are many great games to watch. Gelfand in 2008 won with the black pieces in this position against Mamedyarov, and his game will suggest us the best plan of action. Let's briefly watch the best idea. Long castle is the best idea played by Gelfand, but unfortunately for Ding, not played by Ding, because now it's better for white not to play this knight to d6 we check. Before knight to d6 we check, black is already a bit better. Knight to d6 we check is a bad idea because there is bishop captures, e captures, f5, and black's position is even stronger than before. Let's go back to our game. After this knight jump to e4 instead of long castle, Ding continues following a game played in 2012 by two Chinese grandmasters. Sorry, he continues with the sharper c5. This is playable. This is a sharper move, but with the black king still in the middle of the board, even if c5 is playable, it's probably too risky for a rapid game. As I said before, there is an old game played by two Chinese grandmasters. Ding is probably trying to improve black's play because in that game white won the game. Here comes knight capture on d5 and the bishop recaptures on d5. Knight back to c3, the Chinese game was Li Shilong versus Lu Shangdei, that we know much better, this grandmaster with the black pieces. And in fact, in this position, Ding deviates from that game with the Stockfish suggestion, C capture on d4 instead of bishop to g7. Now, this move is better, but white is still better in this position. Knight captures on d5, the queen is under attack, the e-pawn recapture. But the problem is that after 17 moves, following this obscure variation, Carlsen didn't spend a single second to think about his moves, and he's still in his preparation. In fact, at move 18, he continues with the nice idea, bishop to h5, already played by Del Rio against the strong grandmaster, Russian grandmaster Oleg Kornev, that also wrote some nice chess books. So after bishop to h5, what is the idea? The idea is that there is a lot of pressure against the king, because now the pawn is pinned, e6 is coming, and is really dangerous because the queen can capture the pawn, or rook to e1 will win the queen. And so what to do now? Kornev in 2007 played the safe bishop to e7, and after that move, if white continues with d6, with the king that is not under attack anymore, after rook to e1, the queen can also capture on e6. There is also, instead of bishop to e7 played by Kornev, that is a safe choice, there is also the more aggressive bishop to b4. Instead, Ding continues with knight to c5. And this idea, unfortunately, is a mistake, because Carlsen simply captured with the queen on d4. Not only that, now the knight is pinned, because there is the unprotected queen behind the knight. So white is dominating the position, queen back to e6 unpins the knight and is blocking this dangerous e-pawn. But here comes bishop to g4, protected by the queen, and the black queen is under attack. What to play? Let's go back one move, because I forgot to show you one line. Now in this position, we said white is dominating the game. There is also the chance to immediately play a capture on b5. After a captures on b5, of course, black can't recapture because the pawn is pinned to the rook that is unprotected. This rook capture will also come with check, so it's an immediate game over. But it seems that there is this knight fork that can be dangerous. Instead, it's already more than plus 2 and something, because after knight to b3, it's true that black will win the exchange, but this material gain will not solve the problem of the strong attack against the king still in the center of the board. After knight to b3, of course, the queen moves away, queen to d1, knight captures on a1, bishop to g4, queen to b6, and here comes e6. e6, rook to e1 is coming, so of course the queen can capture. Bishop to e7 is still the best move. Rook to e1, and now short castle for black. But the e-pawn captures on f7, we check. The rook recaptures, and here comes rook to e6, that is controlling this sixth rank with tempo against the queen. Queen captures on b5, bishop to e5 also controlling this important diagonal. Now the problem is that this knight can't move back, because the knight is protecting this important c2 square. So, and if knight to b3, there is queen to c2, and this is a mess. So probably one good idea is queen to b3. Now, of course, white will never change the queens. Queen to d2. It's everything is under attack. It's clear that white is winning, but it's not clear if there is a forcing winning line. Let's go back to our game. So after queen to e6, instead of beginning this long line that begins with a captures on b5, Carlsen continues with the best move, that is bishop to g4 attacking the queen. Instead of moving the queen away, Ding plays this knight fork, knight to b3 attacking the queen and the rook, so queen back to d1, and now of course the queen is under attack, the queen moves away to c6. A captures on b5, the queen is again under attack, so the queen recaptures on b5, and here comes e6. F capture, bishop captures, also this d5 pawn is under attack, rook to a7, bishop captures, and now knight captures on a1. But after queen to f3, Ding resigns because now the queen must move away, because if not, there is the bishop fork that wins the queen. So Ding resigns, because let's briefly continue the game. Where to move this queen? The computer suggests to move the queen to d7, but this is a computer move, because better to move the queen not on the light squares. Queen to b6. Now rook to e1 comes with check. Rook to e7 will lead to a simple checkmate. Let's watch. After rook to e7, the rook is also threatening to capture, but is pinned. So bishop to f7 comes with check, and the rook can't capture. King to d7, rook to d1 with check. King to c8, the queen moves to a8 with check. Queen to b8, but there is the bishop, and queen captures on b8 is checkmate. So let's go back to our rook to e1. Bishop to e7 again is the best idea. There is bishop to c6 with check, so that's why this queen to d7 was a mistake. Rook to d7, again shielding the king, but this rook is pinned. Rook to d1, two pieces attacking the rook, only protected by the king. Queen to a7, but here comes queen to f5. Three attackers, only two defenders, not possible to add a third one, and this is game over, and checkmate will come soon. After six rounds, Carlsen is still undefeated, Ding is still at the bottom of the standings. I really hope that you like this short game, and as usual, if you did, don't forget to like the video and to subscribe to the channel. Thank you very much for watching, and see you soon. Goodbye!